Baby Alan has been growing in his mother's womb for quite some time. Recent ultrasound scanning showed that he was much bigger than normal and was surrounded with excessive fluid. The scanning revealed that Alan's mouth was wide open and his tongue stretched far forward. On closer investigation, a large tumor was found growing in the neck under the jaw. The tumor could prevent normal swallowing and breathing functions. If the situation was not rectified, Alan might suffocate at birth. The doctor decided to operate on Alan at birth to remove the tumor so that he could breathe comfortably as he came into the world. Dolphins can swim in water at high speed, miraculously avoiding obstacles and enemies and hunting skillfully for food. It would be impossible for dolphins to learn about their surrounding environment and make judgments at the same time if they simply relied on their eyesight. They emit ultrasound to detect food and navigate using sonar. A sound wave is a kind of mechanical wave. When sound travels in a medium, the particles of that medium vibrate forward and backward. The vibration of a particle initiates the vibration of neighboring particles. Sound can then be propagated outwards. A sound in a medium is reflected when it meets obstacles. The reflected sound is called an echo. Sonar echoes are used for navigation and range finding. The upper limit of audio frequency detectable by the human ear is about 20,000 Hz. Some animals, like bats and dolphins, navigate and hunt by emitting pulses of sound of 30,000 to 100,000 Hz and listening to the echoes. As the human ear cannot hear sounds with frequencies over 20,000 Hz, these sound waves are called ultrasounds. In 1912, on its first voyage to the United States, the great ocean liner Titanic crashed into an iceberg and sank to the ocean floor. To salvage the wreck, people started to design underwater detection systems by making use of ultrasonic waves. These systems are called sonar. The use of ultrasound in medical diagnosis began in 1940. The method involves emitting ultrasonic waves of 1 MHz to 5 MHz by using an ultrasonic transducer. Pulses of ultrasound inside the human body are reflected from the organs and tissues, enabling us to ascertain their position and distance by considering the time it takes for the echoes to bounce back. In 1880, the French scientists, the Curie brothers, discovered the piezoelectric effect in some crystals. This brought about a breakthrough in the development of echo sounding techniques. When a crystal is stretched or compressed, electric charges appear on the surface of the crystal, building up an electric potential. This is known as the piezoelectric effect. On the other hand, when an electric field acts on a crystal, the crystal is compressed or elongated, resulting in the converse piezoelectric effect or electrostrictive effect. In ultrasound scanning, piezoelectric effect and the converse piezoelectric effect are utilized to create and receive ultrasonic waves. The core component of an ultrasonic scanner is a transducer or a probe. The ultrasound probe is placed on the location to be scanned, the belly of a pregnant woman, for example. The crystal inside the probe emits a pulse of ultrasound which goes through the body. Upon reflection, the ultrasound is received by the crystal and converted into an alternating voltage under the piezoelectric effect. The signals are converted by the computer into visual images. When ultrasonic waves are reflected from moving objects, the sound frequencies vary slightly with the speed of the objects. Known as the Doppler shift, this is a result of the Doppler effect. Nowadays, the Doppler effect is commonly applied in ultrasound imaging to examine the movement of liquids, such as blood flow in arteries and veins, allowing the location of blockages to be determined precisely. Another common medical application is in fetal heartbeat monitoring. The bones become blue in color. The flesh has disappeared completely. A skeleton dangles before us surrealistically. This is the skeleton of a living person. The skeleton of Joyce. Joyce had a tumor in the breast. The doctor operated on her and removed the tumor, but in order to be sure that the cancer had not spread to the bones, the doctor performed radioisotope imaging on Joyce. The results show that the cancer has not spread, and now Joyce can be at ease. Scientists have been making use of radioisotopes for medical imaging since 1940. Since then, the technology involved has improved. Radioisotope imaging is widely used nowadays. An atom consists of an extremely small, positively charged nucleus surrounded by a cloud of negatively charged electrons. If for some reason the nucleus is unstable, it undergoes radioactive decay. In 1899, Ernest Rutherford discovered that a uranium compound produces three kinds of radiation. He separated the radiations according to their penetrating abilities and named them alpha, beta, and gamma rays. When there are too many nucleons in a nucleus, there will be excessive repulsion. To reduce the instability of the nucleus caused by repulsion, the nucleus emits an alpha particle, or helium nucleus. The emission of alpha rays by an unstable nucleus is known as alpha decay. When the neutron to proton ratio is too great, the nucleus is also unstable. This results in beta decay, where a neutron in a nucleus changes into a proton and emits a beta particle, or electron. Sharing the energy with the beta particle is a neutrino. The neutrino has little or no mass and is uncharged, but it carries momentum and energy. Gamma rays are a type of electromagnetic radiation. Gamma decay occurs in a nucleus at a high energy state. The neutron and proton in the nucleus reposition themselves, after which the nucleus returns to a low energy state, emitting a gamma ray. A gamma ray is a high energy photon with very short wavelength. With the development of the gamma camera technique, the use of radioisotope imaging became a common practice in nuclear medicine. Single photon emission computed tomography, or SPECT, is a type of emission computed tomographic imaging technology. Under this imaging method, a dose of radioisotopes is injected into the human body. As alpha and beta rays are absorbed by the body, only gamma rays are detected by the scanner or gamma camera. The doctor makes use of different types of radioisotope for scanning. In a bone scan for damaged bone matrix architecture, for example, the doctor injects the radioisotope of phosphate into the human body. The doctor can also extract a patient's blood sample, spin it in a centrifuge and isolate the white blood cells and label them with the radioactive isotope. The white blood cells are injected into the patient again to find the locations of infection. In the SPECT equipment, a scintillation counter is used to detect gamma photons. The counter consists of a large disc of sodium iodide crystal, typically 40 centimeters in diameter and 1 centimeter thick. To this are attached an array of photomultiplier tubes arranged in a geometric pattern. Sodium iodide is a kind of scintillation material. It emits a flash of light upon absorption of gamma rays. radiation of gamma rays brings the electrons inside an atom to an excited energy level. The electrons return to the ground state quickly and emit the energy they've absorbed in the form of light. The photomultiplier tube attached behind and close to the sodium iodide disc multiplies the light emitted from the crystal. The photocathode of the tube is a thin layer of semiconductor coating. Light from the sodium iodide crystal ejects electrons from the photocathode. These photoelectrons are then accelerated and multiplied by a series of electrodes called dynodes, held at increasingly positive potentials along the tube. The dynodes cause several secondary electrons to be emitted by the energetic incident electron. This process is repeated several times, causing multiplication each time. The electrons are eventually connected by the anode and put out through a further amplifier. It's able to amplify the original light output by a factor of 100,000 to 100 million times. The gamma rays emitted from the human body pass through an array of collimators and reach the sodium iodide crystal. A collimator is used to restrict the directions from which the gamma rays are received. This ensures that only those gamma rays are received which are emitted at right angles to the crystal. The photomultiplier tubes will receive signals from each flash of light in the crystal. Because they're different distances from it, the intensity will differ. With the help of some smart electronics, the position of each flash of light can be deduced. The computer then transforms the data into visual images. SPECT can provide information on the functions of different organs. It's helpful in the diagnosis of the proliferation of cancer and the assessment of the effectiveness of a treatment. Michael Robinson is a British professional in computers and administration. Earlier in the year, he moved to Hong Kong with his wife and child to work for an IT company. For Michael, a new job and a new environment bring hope and challenges. But his hope was almost shattered by a piece of bad news. During a routine physical examination, a lung nodule was found. The doctor could perform a biopsy on Michael, but this would pose the potential hazard of bleeding and pneumothorax, which is an air leak in pleural space leading to lung collapse. Can you imagine the scene in the corridor of the hospital? A happy family was about to be torn apart by a cruel disease. Fortunately, positron emission computed tomography, or PET, revealed that the nodule showed completely normal metabolism. It was just a benign tumor. The family rejoiced at the scanning results, and their happiness was shared by the people around them. Cancer cells are those malfunctioning cells which multiply in an uncontrolled mechanism. When they grow and divide, the cancer cells absorb large amounts of nutrients, including glucose, amino acids, and fatty acids. Adding positron radioisotopes into these substances creates visible glucose, visible amino acids, and visible fatty acids. If we inject them into the human body, we can detect the locations of abnormal metabolism inside. Positron tomography involves the integration of two types of technology, the tracer kinetic assay method and computed tomography. The tracer kinetic assay method involves the injection of a radio-labeled biologically active compound into the body and the measurement of the concentration of the tracer by the use of a PET scanner. The final result is a three-dimensional image of the anatomic distribution of the biological process under study. PET is an advanced type of emission tomography. As compared with other nuclear medicine tomography methods, it can more accurately locate radioactive nuclides and quantify the in vivo measurement of functional processes. The high temporal and spatial resolution makes dynamic imaging possible. An electron is usually negatively charged. Positively charged electrons are known as positrons. Positrons are emitted from the nucleus of some radioisotopes that are unstable because they contain excessive protons. Positron emission stabilizes the nucleus by removing a positive charge through the conversion of a proton into a neutron. A cyclotron is a specially designed electromagnetic device that allows scientists to accelerate charged particles or ionized atoms to very high speeds. These high-speed particles collide with targets composed of various elements, compounds, or gases to produce the required quantities of unique, short-lived PET materials. A cyclotron consists of a pair of hollow, semicircular metal electrodes called Ds. The electrodes are positioned between the poles of a large electromagnet. The Ds are separated from one another by a narrow gap. In the middle is an ion source for the generation of charged particles, such as the positively charged hydrogen ion, which is in fact a proton. The basic principle that made the cyclotron possible is the fact that an orbiting particle in a magnetic field takes the same time to make one revolution, regardless of radius or energy. An alternating voltage on the Ds can be set to match the revolution frequency of all the particles in the cyclotron. This is called the resonance condition, because the accelerating force varies so as to be always in the direction of particle motion. As such, the protons accelerate each time they pass the gap. As they speed up, the protons follow an outwardly spiraling path. The orbiting protons synchronize or are in resonance with the alternating voltage. When the beam of protons from the cyclotron accelerate to a particular speed, they enter into the target chamber, where they collide with the stable nucleus of the target material, resulting in the production of a radioactive isotope. The emitted positron from a decayed nucleus travels a short distance of about 4 to 5 millimeters and collides with an electron of a nearby atom. In an annihilation reaction, a positron merges with an ordinary electron to produce a positronium. It immediately turns into two gamma photons, a 511 kilo electron volt, each traveling at 180 degrees to each other. This characteristic is made use of in PET. Before scanning, radioisotopes are injected into the human body. These circulate to all parts of the body, such as the brain tissue and the heart tissue, through the bloodstream. With the emission of positron and the annihilation reaction, the PET machine accurately detects the position where the two gamma photons formed. In the scanner, there are several ring detectors. Scintillated materials are used to detect gamma photons, as in the case of SPECT. Two gamma photons traveling in opposite directions are detected at the same time. The position of the radioactive nucleus can thus be accurately determined. The information is fed into a computer to generate visual images. PET helps us get a better understanding of the normal and abnormal biochemical functions of human organs and provides a means for medical workers to perform imaging of the biological process under natural conditions.